Day 250 of the coronavirus lockdown. I still haven't caught the dreaded coronavirus. I'm starting to think that it's all a myth. A conspiracy. A hoax. Luckily, I've been able to avoid catching it. Hopefully, it's not real. Food and toilet roll is still scarce. Luckily, I've been able to do nightly runs. I've been breaking into people's houses at night and taking as much supplies as I can. Toilet roll and beans. You have no idea how valuable these are. If you're watching in the future and the pandemic is over, think yourself lucky. Beans are currency right now. And toilet paper is life. As I stated before, I've not caught the coronavirus yet. I've been lucky. I still don't think that it's real. But just in case, I've been wearing my mask in public. It's day 250 of the coronavirus lockdown. And I've decided to go for a walk.
Now here we are, outside of the church of coronavirus. Before the coronavirus pandemic, there was Christianity, Islam, Judaism, and the church of the Buddhist monk. But ever since the coronavirus has hit and destroyed 99% of the population, many religious leaders believe that it was sent by God himself. And so, the Church of the Coronavirus was formed. Here lies some of the many people who have passed on from coronavirus. The numbers are quite substantial, as you can see. If you listen very closely, you can actually hear the followers of the Church of the Coronavirus inside, praying, singing, dancing, and sacrificing those non-believers like myself. Being here is a big risk. If they catch me, knowing that I am a non-believer, they will sacrifice me to their god, COVID-19, in hopes that the coronavirus pandemic does end. It's ironic. Such beautiful singing, such beautiful music, accompanied by such violence, such horror. So many. So many lost. Thanks a lot, China. A stark reminder to always wash your hands. And here we are now. At docks. This place used to be teeming with life. Fishermen, docksmen, people who spend their time on boats, and now it's just a graveyard. When the coronavirus pandemic hit, many people tried to escape on boats, the ones that still worked. Some of the infected tried to escape too. As you can see, these two had coronavirus. Their boat sunk. In rare cases, the coronavirus turned people to stone. And that's what happened to these two unlucky souls. A stark reminder to always wash your hands.
During the apocalypse, it's important that you carry on working out, keeping in shape. You're going to be doing a lot of scavenging, a lot of climbing. And it's very important that you keep your stamina up. Like me, I'm in perfect physical condition. We've come to the point in our journey where it's getting dark, I'm getting hungry. But where do you eat in the apocalypse? Apocalyptic KFC. And I'm going to show you how to make a Kentucky Apocalyptic Mini Philip Burger. Now the first thing we're going to need for our Kentucky Apocalyptic Mini Philip Burger is the buns. Now I know these are not actual buns, but we'll have to make do. So we've got the top bun and the bottom bun. And then we're gonna need some lettuce. My favorite. Now, when it comes to chicken in the apocalypse, they're actually extinct. Most people are eating rat meat. However, I'm vegan. So we're gonna grab as many of those brown leaves as we can, the same ones we used for the burger bun. And we're gonna scrunch them up, as many as you want, as hungry as you are, use as many as you can. And what we're going to do is we're going to place these on top of our lettuce and our bun. Now, how do we make our chicken leaves taste different to our bun leaves? Simple, salt. And where do we get salt in the apocalypse? Sea and sand. Just grab as much sand as you can. And what we do with that is we just grind it up in our hands like so. And we keep grinding up until the texture feels slightly different. And now we've got salt, you see? And we sprinkle that on our burger. Now, as you see, we've got our bottom bun, we've got our chicken, we've got our lettuce seasoned, and all what's left to do is place the top bun on the top, like so, and voila, there you have it. The Kentucky Apocalyptic Mini Chicken Philip Burger. Now let's try it and see what it's like. That's a really good burger. Now we've been for our walk, we've had our Kentucky Apocalyptic Mini Chicken Philip Burger, and it's starting to get dark. Well, it is dark, and this is where the cannibals and the scavengers come out. So I'm gonna go home now, rest up. Once again, we've avoided getting... we've avoided catching the coronavirus. Remember to wash your hands, cover your face, and keep space. I'll see you next time on the next walk.